Talk Time, and today we're going to feature Jack Black. It's like a Jack Black attack. So if you've never heard of this company, we're going to give you a little info on it. Have you ever had a piece of cake or a really good cup of coffee? Make me feel. And it feels so much better and tastes so much better when somebody else makes it for you. So we realize that we can recognize a good product and we could probably, well not probably, we could make it ourselves.
Right, I mean the tough thing is like we're two people, we can't make everything. And there's a lot of brands out there that are quality brands and they get, you know, the whole product line. At some point in time, Diana and John had to say, we've done enough, this is what we're going to make, and we're going to find those other brands out there that make a good quality product that we can stand behind and carry them and sell their products.
Yeah, John.
Yeah.
That's right. So they do a great job. They are carried in some good high-end department stores, and if it's good enough for high-end department store, it's good enough for Hazelwood Soap Company. Ain't that right? So we do carry these on our website. And the other thing that we carry on our website are these awesome eco-friendly towels. So I am a little bit of a towel snob, that I feel like life is too short for cheap towels and cheap sheets. You work all day, whether it's at home or out of the house, or if you're a stay-at-home mom or stay-at-home dad. You just want to feel like a natural woman. You want to feel good. So, we're going to use this today because today we got a demo. We're going to make him feel like a little natural woman. One of the things with this Jack Black business is I'm going to give you a little secret, ladies. You can get it for your man. You can get it for your man, but I'm going to tell you right now, this packaging and all these things are geared towards the males, but I think it's a phenomenal product to get for yourself. And then you can share it with your guy, or you can get it for your guy under the guise of getting it for him, but it's really for you. So they do a really good job with their essential oil blends, their lather, their glide, all that kind of stuff. And we all know that those guys are stealing our products, not always fessing up to it. So this is your time, girls. You get it. You get it for your man. So today we're going to talk about this one, Supreme Cream. It comes in a tube or it comes in a tub. For demonstration reasons today, we're going to be using the tube. We're going to get old John Boy here, all lathered up.
Oops.
Whoa. Put your leg up.
I know. It's like my hip wants to pop out of joint.
Welcome to childbirth.
There's some things going on.
Do you want to put this leg up?
No, this is the leg.
Okay.
This,
so we're going to get it all, pretend you're in the shack or the tub. Get it all lathered up. There is another one called Beard Lube. And what that happens with this is that this one, let me just double check to make sure. Comes out clear. So when you put it on, it's so if you have, see that?
It works well as also as a base. You can put that on before you shave. You can shave with that, but it's good as a base.
But I think what it's really good for is if you do have a beard and then you have that moment where you're like, ruh-roh, and you've got the white shave cream and you can't see, this goes on a little bit clear so you can see where you're shaving.
Yes.
So you don't nick that wonderful bushy beard that you've been working so hard on. So here's our Supreme Cream and a little bit of a tube. Smells phenomenal. Same situation going on in the tub if you're one of those that likes to scoop and do that. And then you just go ahead.
Oh, make some booze.
Look at that. Look at a good lather going on.
I need some more Aretha.
Okay. How's that feel, John?
Wonderful.
Wonderful?
I feel alive.
Yeah? Okay. We'll just go gonna give a little glide. This is so disgusting. Wow! Look at that close. Kyle, get in there. Get up in there. Look at that close shave. My word!
Oh, jeez.
Wow! Look at that.
Oh, it's kind of hairy down around the side there.
Wow. Wow. I'll do one more strip. Try to avoid the bug bites.
And the scars and everything. You need a lipstick blade.
I'm just going to show for demonstration purposes. Because who would want a fully shaven leg when you are 6'7"? You got to own
sorry.
It.
I'm sorry. I have no pride left.
Oh, my.
I have no pride.
So, ladies.
Oh, no! Oh, God.
Ladies, you know what's happening. This quarantine isn't gonna let. I'm gonna put a little segment on after. This quarantine ain't gonna last forever, so you're gonna eventually need to go down and tackle those legs. Because I know that you've been neglecting them. It's okay. It's okay. But eventually, you're gonna need to get up in there. So, and then we're going to do a little post-shave cooling gel. Now, let's just pretend this is...
But that's more for your beard.
It is. I'm saying make sure... Let's just pretend for demonstration purposes...
Just a little bit goes a long way.
...that this is his face.
Just a little. That's all you need. Because I've used that before.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh,
I thought it was okay. There you go. I think I have a little bit more.
Yeah, that's okay.
It's okay.
I mean, you only need a little bit. If you use this gel, she put too much on. But it's like, especially around your neck, their cooling gel feels great. And for guys, because you know, you get, that's where all those nicks and razor burns happen.
Girls.
And that gel feels
bikini
really nice.
Season.
And it keeps those bumps from getting all red and just nasty.
Yeah, so I think what they do is they have this aloe sage and lavender in there, and that kind of like tightens up your pores. And then it doesn't allow the ingrown hairs to get irritated. And
it is cooling. You can see the goosebumps are forming.
Bring
on
it head. In. Look at those goosebumps. And there you have it. So this might, now we're going to go into our highs and lows. Here's my eco-friendly towel. This might be John's low.
I have more moments than this. You have no idea.
Okay. Well, we'll save that for another time. Real low moments. Awkward. If you notice, a little campfire mug serves as a great shave mug as well. Didn't know that until today. Functional comfort at its best. So go ahead and fill up your mug. Put your shave cream in there if you want, or just if you're camping, you can use it as well. So highs and lows. You ready?
Sure.
You want to start with lows or highs?
Lows.
Okay, now we're going based on yesterday. So my low yesterday was waking up, out of the bed and looking on the floor, and that's where the coffee was. It had spilled out all over the floor. Now, this is not the first time it's done that. I'm literally going to take that coffee pot, not big, might be another tub talk, and just completely smash it. And I don't even care if I've got to grind up my own god darn beans by myself, by my hands, and smash them. That's what's gonna happen. So that was my low. Coffee all over the floor, and then having to have to start over with the pot and not knowing if it was really gonna produce a cup of coffee.
So my low, I was dropping off cardboard at the recycling center yesterday, and I had to break open a box, and I was fumbling with it in the box cutter, and I knew I was gonna do it just before I did it, but I took the razor blade and sliced the top of my finger right by the bed nail.
Ow!
Yeah, so. That was
wow.
Dumb moment.
Dumb moment. Okay, hi. My high for yesterday was being able to, one, think that I had a lunch break, which I did, and then busting out of here in the middle of the day for a beautiful walk around the neighborhood with Kyla. And we got a good 6 mile loop in. We're able to look around and see these beautiful mountains and think how crazy it is that there is a virus floating around out there because it's so beautiful here. So that was my high.
My high is kind of like that too. It's just like yesterday, this, and it's, I've heard other people say this, like I have a sister in Virginia and just people in different places saying that with all the traffic reduction, it seems like, I don't know if it's real, but it seems like the air has gotten clearer. And it's, you know, it seems like you can see further. So it's been, you know, more beautiful and quieter. So I guess that's kind of a high. A silver lining to all this is that it seems like it's gotten prettier outside.
Yeah, everybody's getting back to basics. But I will tell you that we still are going to be making lots of good stuff. We're going to be running some specials next week. We got another Tub Talk coming on Friday. If you have any special requests or you have any suggestions, we're always taking them. And then that's all we got for today, unless you've got anything else.
No.
Okay. Peace out.
Bye.